Toronto Blue Jays and the Philadelphia Phillies. Coming to the plate now, Rowdy Tellez, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Now the 3-2 pitch. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Stepping in for the Jays, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He'll get to take his first cuts here. A ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away. Next to bat for Toronto, Lourdes Gurriel will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Blue Jays shortstop with a 1-2 count. Pulls this one in the air out to left. McCutcheon is under it. And the inning is over. Gene Segura standing in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
No left fielder, Andrew.
So now to the plate, Andrew McCutcheon. This is line to left. Hernandez has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone.
Harper.
And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
Now you could tell right there that curveball had some serious depth to it. That's what separates the good ones from the bad ones. That nasty spin rate. Get that downward action. You even get a star player like this swinging at something in the dirt.
Liner in there for a base hit. And this will kick off the base of the wall. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
Batting four. The first baseman. Three. Hoskins.
Standing in now, Reese Hoskins. A swing by Hoskins, and this is driven to deep left. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
The third baseman.
At the plate now, Didi Gregorius. A ball and two strikes to Didi Gregorius. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two. So next to the plate for the Phils, JT Realmuto. And the Phils trying to make this first inning even better here. 1-1. Here it is. And this one's in the dirt. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Harper on second. Hoskins on at first with two down. Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher.
Well, he's in a bit of hot water in this first inning, but if he can start throwing his slider effectively like that, he has a lot better chance of settling into this game.
Full count now. The payoff pitch. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed. He got him. So digging in now, Bo Bichette.
The second baseman, number 11.
The 2-1. Phillies have an early 1-0 lead here in inning number two. Is swung on and driven out to right center field. A ball that's well hit, and that is off the wall. And he'll pull into second with one away.
That is fifth. The right fielder, number 15, Randall Grichuk.
Into the box, Randall Grichuk. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Williams is under it. And he makes the catch for the second out. Riding in, Reese McGuire, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. The 1-1. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Sliced hard on the ground, and that's through, a base hit.
Bichette
rounds the corner and is headed home. Safe at the plate. We're all square and one apiece.
Batting it, the center fielder, number 28, Billy McKinney.
Into the box now, Billy McKinney. Three balls and two strikes to the Blue Jays center fielder. Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Up next will be Nick Williams. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 2-1. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. The 2-2. Now here's a ball heading for the right field corner. This has the distance, and it stays fair. Home run. At the plate, Scott Kingery. Looking to drop one down, but he can't make contact. 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
The struggles continue, but that happens when you're not able to locate your secondary pitches. You become a one-pitch pitcher. He needs to start to get those secondary pitches over really fast.
So the base is empty here with one away.
When the pitcher strides into the batter's box, here's Zach Wheeler.
1-1. Is swung on and missed for strike number two. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
The batter, number two.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. Oh, they think they may have gotten him again. This one's hit deep to left field. And for the second time in the inning, the Gopher ball will come back to bite him. It's a home run. In now, Andrew McCutchen. And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. A 3-1 count to the Phillies left fielder.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots. And now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And that'll bring up Bryce Harper. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Hernandez is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Top of the third set to get underway. So in now is the Blue Jays pitcher, Tanner Roark, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Outside, 2-1.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. And sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Count even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Outside and a full count, 3-2. Heading out towards shallow right. Harper has a read on it. One away.
Rowdy Tellez the next to bat. First time up, he went down looking.
Third inning here. 3-1 our score.
A 2-1 count to the Blue Jays first baseman.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
The 3-1 pitch.
It's a fastball center cut.
Fouled away. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a wall. Here's Wheeler on 1-1. A ball and two strikes. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that gets through for a one-out base hit.
The batter, number 13, shortstop, Lourdes.
Standing in now, Lourdes Gurriel. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. A ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Bottom of the third now, so now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Rhys Hoskins, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at-bat. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
Now batting.
Here's Didi Gregorius, 0-for-1 here in the early going.
Gregorius.
And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
Right back into a good hitter's count now after what was a pretty dreadful second.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Gone! Stepping in now, JT Realmuto. Hard hit ball to second. And boy, the Phillies just keep right on rolling as this will be extra bases again. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
The center fielder, number 5, Nick.
So now to the plate, Nick Williams. And there's ball two now. Hit in the air to shallow center. McKinney coming in. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. So one gone here in the Philadelphia third, and that'll bring up the former first rounder, Scott Kingery. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
When he's pitching effectively, usually that two-seam fastball is moving quite a bit, but here it's just kind of flat and straight. Could be a big part of the reason why he's getting knocked around.
Tellez is over now, and he's got it for route number two. Next up will be the Phillies pitcher, Zach Wheeler. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Wheeler.
A little bit outside. 2-1.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Now the payoff pitch home is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. New inning set to get underway.
Trying to pick things up where he left off.
Bo Bichette. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it.
Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Oh, and this deflects right off him. And that's off the left field wall. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
The right fielder, number 15, Randall Gritchick.
Into the box, Randall Gritchick. The slider up into the 90s there. It's 1-2. Outside and low that time. Now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Reese McGuire will be next. Fly ball out toward left center field. McCutcheon on the move. He makes the catch, and tagging is the runner from second. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Now batting, Reese McGuire looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. Lays off, 2-2 now. 5-1 our score as we play the fourth here. Still 2-2. Grounded up the first baseline. Hoskins grabs it cleanly. He'll go to the bag for one, but one's all they get as the run scores. Stepping in, Billy McKinney. He'll try and start things over now with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground ball. Got caught lunging there as this one's fouled away. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Again, he sends it out of play.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
Another one sent foul. The next 1-2 pitch. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up Gene Segura. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
And in that last at bat, it makes you think this guy might have went up there looking for the breaking ball, because he certainly got a breaking ball, and he didn't miss it. Hit it right on the screws.
And oh, look out, up and in, and nearly took his head off.
He went deep earlier, so that might have been a little bit of a message they were trying to send to get him off the plate. At the very least, they're clearly trying to get him from getting his arms extended again.
Softly hit out to short, and one gone. Into the box, Andrew McCutcheon. It was a walk in his last trip. Fourth inning here, already a 5-2 score. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball. Trouble waiting on deck as Bryce Harper hits next. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. Throw on to first, two gone. Here's Bryce Harper now, 1-for-2, including a double back in the first. 5 runs, 7 hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. 2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed, 2-2. Still even at 2-2. And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Digging in to try it again, Tanner Roark comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pitch for strike number 2.
hit the other way out toward right field. Harper has a read on it. One out. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. Now here's a swing by Tellez as he gets a lot of this one out to deep right field. And gone. An absolute bomb. To the plate now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. This one's down to third. Gregorius has it. Throw gets him. Two down. So striding in, Nordis Gurriel. He went down on strikes last time up. Three runs, five hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. 3-1.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit.
Goes the other way and sends it deep down the right field line. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
Now batting, the left fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
At the plate, Teoscar Hernandez. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two. Count remains 2-2. Full count, 3-2.
Wow, these guys are really grinding out their at-bats in this one. They're not making any outs easy to get. And that, of course, is having a huge impact on the pitch count.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Hit sharply on the ground. Segura gets down on the ground. Great play. Got him. That was exceptional. He got the out and prevented the runner from having a chance to score. And now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Phillies, Reese Hoskins, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway. So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. Onto the shortstop, but thrown away. Luckily for them, the left fielder retrieves this ball quickly. Chase Anderson comes on now in an awfully difficult situation as there are two on here with nobody out. JT Realmuto will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. Back to the fastball, but it's upstairs. Two balls and two strikes now.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in. Make him prove he can adjust before you do.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
And that's through into center field. Base hit. Play at the plate, and he's out. A great throw. Standing in now, Scott Kingery. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Jake Arrieta makes his way toward the mound now as he'll appear in his sixth ball game of the spring. Top half of the sixth about to get started. At the plate, Bo Bichette. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at-bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
And
And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
His history with Jake Arrieta, he has an even 10 hits in 24 at-bats.
He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now.
Grichuk puts a good swing on it. This ball's carrying well to left. McCutchen
is on the warning track as he hauls it in for a loud out number one.
Settling in now, Reese McGuire.
He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. And this one's in the dirt.
Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1.
From the belt, the pitch. And it's belted high and deep into right center.
Ranging back is Williams.
But he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. The relay.
Throw won't get him.
Cole Irvin comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
Stepping in now,
Billy McKinney.
Lifted in the air to shallow center field.
Williams
has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And even with two away now, that ball just didn't get out there deep enough, so they'll hold him at third base. Line drive to center field. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. And the second run will score as well.
Now batter, number 44.
In now,
Rowdy Tellers.
Sent on the ground out to second.
Kingery's there.
Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired.
Sean Reed Foley enters
to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Neil Walker
is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Walker lays off there. It's two balls and a strike. Bounced on the ground and right at the shifted infielders. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
The batter, number two.
Digging in now for Philadelphia, Gene Segura. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point.
The 1-2 is laid off for ball two. Lined hard and deep down the left field line. Ah, but he just missed his extra bases. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. On deck, there's Andrew McCutchen. He'll hit next. And he fouls this one off. Once again, a 3-2. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Up next for Philadelphia.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. The 2-2 one more time. Line towards center field. And that'll get down for a two-out single.
So Bryce Harper will get a chance to hit here this inning following the base hit.
The right fielder, number 3.
At the plate now, Bryce Harper. And here's a fastball not close as he runs it to 2-1 now. Hit hard down the line. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. From the stretch. Frozen on the fastball. Never had a chance, and the inning is over. Christopher Sanchez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Jonathan Davis is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. And it's 1-2. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. 2-2 count. Here it comes. Pulls this one in the air out to left. McCutcheon is under it, and that's the first out of the inning. Brendan Drury will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Set to deal on 2-2. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick 2 outs to start the 7th. Anthony Alford will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with 2 out and the bases empty. Line toward the alley in left center. That gets down, and the inning continues. Santiago Espinal will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Santiago Espinal.
Swing and a miss, strike 2.
Hey, no shame in that. Your eyes light up when that heater comes above the belt. That's so tough to lay off of.
So a full count now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a line drive. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit. And that's going to move that go-ahead run to second now with 2 gone. Kevin Biggio will start to loosen up in the on-deck circle as he'll bat with 2 on and 2 out here. 2 down, runners at first and second. Hard hit toward the hole, and that's through into left, a base hit. The throw to the plate. He's in there at the plate, and they've taken the lead here in the 7th.
Now batting, number 10.
Into the box now, Reese McGuire. Into the corner and slicing foul. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Hit out towards second. He's right there. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Justin Miller will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Danny Jansen is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. Adam Haseley will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Now playing left, number 30, Anthony Alford. Now at shortstop, number 3, Brandon.
Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now, 3-1.
Great situation right here, leading off the inning. You've got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Oh, that hit him. Let's hope he's okay. And they still managed to get an out on the play. Whoa. Josh Harrison will come on as a pinch hitter.
Now it's perfect. Number 7. Josh.
Bases are empty. 1 man out.
This game's defensively for the Blue Jays. Now playing first base. Number 40. Adam.
Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. Harrison
often known as Jay Hay around the game. He was taken in the sixth round during the 2008 draft.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way in the big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
So it was a swinging strike three. Josh Harrison becomes the second out of the bottom of the seventh. And that misses, 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. Nick Williams would be next. The 3-1 pitch. Grounded back up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. So now to the plate, Nick Williams. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Victor Arano will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jay Bruce will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. That'll bring up Billy McKinney, and he hasn't quite had the same fortune at the plate as many of his teammates. No hits for him so far.
Number seven.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Harrison in foul ground, and no one will track it down.
Number 73, J.B. Grouillon.
Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Now batter, number 9.
Up next is Danny Jansen, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. The 1-2.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more apt to expand the strike zone, but he didn't and held off on that one that wasn't even close.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Number 44.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. Now he lifts a high pop up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Forsyth is over, and he tucks it away for the second out. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that brings up the left-handed hitter, Travis Shaw. Hit hard down the left field line, but this is going to get foul. Set to deal on 2-2. Line toward the gap in left center, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Now batting, shortstop, Brandon Drury.
At the plate, Brandon Drury. Two balls and a strike. Strike two as he locks him up there. He's set. The 2-2. And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Stepping up now, Scott Kingery. No hits for him yet in the game despite his team's offensive onslaught.
The 1-1 home. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. Right to him. Throw to first is in time for the first down. At the plate, Jay Boots. One out, nobody on. Swung on by Bruce, and he connects with it to right field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Stepping in now, Gene Segura. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Hit in the air to center field. McKinney's there for it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Roman Quinn will come on now as the pinch hitter.
Pinch hitting for the Phillies. Number 24. Roman Quinn.
He lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. And Bryce Harper will dig in at the plate. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. The 1-1.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. That being very aggressive right now.
Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. All even now, 2-2. Now a throw over to first, and the runner back in standing. Full count now, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Here's the payoff pitch. Yank fouled off to the right. High in the air and deep to left center field. Alford looking up. And that two-run home run delivers an eighth-inning lead. Thomas Hatch enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning.
Number 59, Thomas Hatch.
In now, Logan Forsythe. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts? Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back-to-back jacks. Standing in now, Josh Harrison. Down the third baseline. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Touché, sir. Hector Neris takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. Forrest Wall is going to be asked to try and be the rally starter as he's up off the bench, ready to lead it off in the ninth.
Wall.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
The second baseman.
So stepping in, Santiago Espinal, a base hit in his first trip. Ball and two strikes now.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Still 1-2. A runner at first with no outs here. A bouncer up the middle. Kingery's there. Segura for one. On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now. Josh Palacios will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. Throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Yeah, and the home crowd is loving it as they jumped out in front in the bottom of the eighth, and they did what they had to do in the ninth to seal the deal.
9-6, the final tally in this one. The Philadelphia Phillies posted four runs in the eighth on the way to victory. Victor Arano pitches well enough to get the W. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vasgersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time.
Afternoon. First for the victorious Philadelphia Phillies, 9 runs on 13 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Blue Jays, 6 runs on 12 hits. 1 error. They left 9 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours exactly. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.